The Lions say the use of No-Doz before games is a non-issue. In the wake of Ben Cousins' health scare, footage emerged of tablets being distributed in the Brisbane dressing room. But Michael Voss can't see what the fuss is about.
The AFL says the image of its stars taking pre-match doses of No-Doz is a bad look, but the Lions coach says it's no big deal.
I'm not 100% sure what the issue is, to be truthful. As far as I'm aware, that it's, you know, it's okay to do.
He says it's an individual choice.
Some players do it, some players don't, but, you know, I did for a while and I found no benefit in it whatsoever, so I stopped.
No benefit, but doctors warn there could be a cost.
In addition to their heart racing, which can cause problems, they can get quite dehydrated.
The Brisbane Broncos say their players don't use caffeine stimulants before games. Caffeine was removed from the banned list in 2004, but World Anti-Doping Agency WADA is closely monitoring its status in light of this week's revelations about widespread use.
There are concerns about the message being sent to young sports people, especially as tens of thousands take the field this weekend, hoping to copy the feats of their heroes.
Again, Michael Voss says it's blown out of proportion.
The last time I checked, a 12-year-old can still buy a coffee at a coffee shop.
But I think what we're talking about here are much higher doses of caffeine with the intent or the purpose of trying to improve their sporting prowess. And I don't think that's a good message to send children.
And as for athletes taking sleeping pills to dull the No-Doz after the full-time siren...
Wouldn't it just be easier if you didn't take the first drug that you needed the second drug to counteract?
WADA will update its prohibited list in October. Max Futcher, 10 News.